Hello everyone, this is Sri Chandan Venkat. Welcome to my channel. So today we will start up with hypermesh. This is what the first tutorial you need to learn, and I already told in the previous class what are the prerequisite tiles you need to put it in mixed. This should be in element by quality, or it is not necessary for you guys to keep it in by element quality now itself. Better you keep it in by component and make sure you are working on OptiStrut. Yeah, these are the basic prerequisites you need to know, and you need to be in a new model, because whenever sometimes it might take the previous model. So please make sure you are working on a new model. So before going to that, I'll tell you what are all the things you need to learn, right? So before going to that, I'll explain to you the UI part, that we call it as graphical user interface. So this part we call it as a tab area, this part we call it as tab area, and these are toolbars, these are the toolbars, and this is graphical area which you can draw, is called graphical area. And this is menu panel or menu pages, you call. You have geometry, one dimension, two dimension, three dimension, analysis, tool, post, everything is discussed over here. And these are pull downs, like if you click on it, you have extra parts. So these are called pull downs. So this is basically, and these nodes and every all the stuff over here is main menu. So in our class, the basic things what we need to learn is geometry first. So after that, you can learn one dimension, two dimension, three dimension, analysis, tools, post processing, all this stuff. But before going to all this stuff, you need to be very much clear with geometry, and I'll help you guys to understand each and every step very clearly, right? So these are the parts you need to learn. So basically, you need to start with nodes, then you need to know how to draw lines, then you need to know how to create surfaces, then after solids, and if there is any extension or any modification, you can edit it. So everywhere you will have node creation and node addition, line creation, line edit, surface, surface edit, solid, solid edit. So these are the stuff line by line in a sequential manner we will be learning it. Basically, first one will be nodes. So this is node. If I keep 0, 0, 0, means what happens at origin, you are trying to create a node. So what happens, you can zoom it, you can see. So control and scroll button is for zooming, and you can see this is origin. If I want to create on x-axis around 10, just create it. So you can zoom out, so you can see it. Yeah, so control scroll is a zoom in zoom out condition, you can make it. So this is 10, 10, right? If I want to create another like 20, you can see again, create 20, it will create on y-axis. If I want to create, you know it, right? So 10, create, 20, create, like that you can create as many as possible, right? Yeah. So this is, just take 10 and 20, create, 20 and 20, create, 20 and 10, 10, 10, Yeah, you can create like this. These are the possible ways. Here itself, in this itself, I'll tell you how to use lines. So this is line, right? In this, there is a condition called, similarly you can create condition called node list. In this, what happens, you just need to click on nodes, first node, second node, and press scroll button. You can be able to create lines between those nodes. Control Z. 1, 2 nodes, 1, 2 nodes, 1, 2 nodes. So likewise, you can create lines. Not only here, whatever the possible options we have, I'll let you know about it, because it will not only help you to understand the concept, it will also help you to where to use and what to use. This will help you. Are you getting the point or not? So here, this is what the option, with the help of coordinate axis, you can be able to create it. Next thing is lines. On lines I want to create. So here you have points, here you have lines. On surfaces also you can create, on plane also you can create. Let us see each and every option. I'm clicking on line. Just click on this line and click somewhere over here. That's it. Directly you'll be able to get it. Those are the option of line. Just click line and click on the line wherever you want to have. It will produce it. That is the basic stuff, right? Next, similarly, if I have surface, I need to have surface, right? Before that, I'll tell you how to create surface of these lines. So I have drawn these nodes. In order to remove all these nodes, what should I do means Shift F2. You need to press shortcut keys Shift F2 and clear all. So it will be cleared. Yeah, this is what basic stuff. If I want to create surface, I'll clear it. See, before that, I just want to remove these lines. If I want to remove this line, you can go to line edit. Or else you can also delete them as well. Did you get the point or not? So I can delete the line as well. So click on it. If you want to delete the lines, click F2. F2 is the shortcut key. Not only for lines, you can also create, you can also delete lines, you can also delete elements, you can also delete points. Here there are lot many stuff you have it. So click on lines and click on the line which you want to delete and press middle button or scroll button. Click on the line and press scroll button. Click on the line and press scroll button. So these are the things you need to learn before going to meshing and all this stuff. So I want to create surface. So I am interpreting nodes, lines and surface in a sequential manner. So you can skills. So you can also understand how we are creating nodes, then after lines, and then after surfaces. So if you are going with surfaces, so here you have an option, right? So with the help of lines, you don't have any condition. So surface with respect to lines, right? So N1. So in order to produce surfaces, you need to go to surface. Here you have an option called spline. So spline is asking you lines. So click on lines, all the lines and create. So you can see a surface is created over here. So this is how you can create surface with the help of lines, given lines. So if I don't want this surface, just go to component and click on this. So it represents surface. So if you click on this, you can off this. You have another option as well. Here you have an option called wireframe entity. So you can remove the surface itself, not lines. Here if you put it, everything will disappear. But whereas here only surfaces will be removed. And here if you want to regain the surface, you need to click on the surface. So I hope you guys understood it. And let us come back to nodes again. Here why I have gone to produce a surface or derive a surface is, here in nodes you have seen lines, right? So in order to produce points or nodes on a surface, we need to have a surface. So that's why I have elaboratively explained the other stuff. So if you go to surface and click on the surface, and you can click anywhere on the surface, so directly you can produce nodes on the surface written. So this is how you will be able to produce nodes. So this is for a circle line, circular lines, especially used for circles. This is lines. So Shift F2, I'm clearing all this stuff, right? So this is line. If I have a line, I want to produce three number on it. So just click on it, number over here, and click on it. I want to produce 5 on it. Keep 5 over here. So that is how it will be helpful. And this is helpful to draw or create nodes between two nodes. So this is one node and this is another node. If I want to create 5 nodes in between these two nodes, you can use this option. So I hope you guys understood it. And this is especially used when you have two lines intersection. So one line, two line, sorry, one line, and the second, this is second line, create. So at the intersection of two lines, you will get a node. This is all about node. I hope you guys understood about it. And in next class, we'll see how to create nodes, how to edit nodes, and all this stuff. And please do subscribe to my channel. If you are clear with it, click on like button, and thank you.